I tell people at times that the strongest weapon in the lives of times is money. One pastor one day was casting a demon from one guy.
In the name of Jesus, you spirit, who are you?
The spirit did not answer.
Who are you?
The spirit said, I'm Marion from Zumaro.
What do you want from this body? What do you want from this body?
I want to give him $1 million before the end of this year and take over his spirit. The pastor changed it.
I command you right now, in the name of Jesus, since you have the ability of giving $1 million, leave this body and enter my body.
I read the money for the call. So if you get $1 million, you just come the first day. I was telling you something in the city of Okada that sometimes if you preach, some preaching and some messages, you get some message, they will say, after the message, you need to say, don't try this at home. For some people who don't have faith. You know, I tell people that the reason why some believers cast demons, if God open your eyes, you know, sometimes we cast out demons, we don't imagine them. And thank God for that heart. Because if God has created, imagine, as a Christian, if you cast out demons, you see them. You know, some of us, we just imagine, we don't see. Say, demon, a spirit of poverty, you get like this. No. Now, let's imagine, once you call, in the name of Jesus, Jesus will appear. Kono, kono. Say, I command you, wicked spirit. You will see the wicked spirit.
Kono, kono.
Some prayers will change.
Say, in the name of Jesus,
Jesus will appear. You will see him.
Say, you evil spirit,
you go see like 1 million, you go say, I respect you. Come in Jesus' name, my dear.
Then all you men of little faith, you get the kind of demon where you go, they cast, but when you know, say, even if you appear, you go feel killer. You foul spirit,
foul appear, you match.
So, the ones you cast out are going to be the ones you can face, kuro kuro. When church one day, pastor was preaching and said, David, at the age of 17, killed a bear with his bare hands. After the message, the pastor was going on the team. David, just at 17, killed a bear with bare hands. David,
one guy, a deacon in the church, and his name is David, he's about 56 years. After the whole message, the man went home and was like, am I not David? At the age of 17, David killed bear with a hand, and I'm almost 57. I can kill two. The guy came back to the house. Our landlord's dog, if you see this dog, Rottweiler. The guy was waiting after like 20 minutes when people have left the compound. The guy carried the dog. Go back here. Dropped the dog somewhere. You know, never now the dog will look the man as that's when he know. You know, say the man don't change after him. Say if David at the age of 17, those days, keep them with your hands, I will kill you. I just want you to destroy the miracle. The dog was still looking like the man. So you don't want to talk, you don't want to say anything. You get look.
Like say you challenge me, what did I go do you?
Stupid dog. The moment you knock the dog out for you, the dog go, huh?
You won't challenge me. Wait, you won't challenge David of this day.
When he rush the dog, boom, the dog pinch a small pinch back. He stop, bring that info. Man of God, say yeah. Please, I want to confirm something. When David tried to kill the bear, did the bear bite him or kill him? The man of God replied, you know the Bible did not put everything some things in detail. Normal fight, there must have been bruises or something. You know, after the OT dropped the call, he rushed the dog again. Man, the dog was just sitting as a follow dog. And they play for grand, the dog, when he now pressed the dog's neck, and the dog rushed up. The next day for church, if you see the guy, he'll be like, wolf. I tell people the good thing about, sometimes being born again is not just about the miracle. Being born again naturally is good for the health.
Because there are some things that if you see what people who are not born again do, sometimes imagine that this human being. One man went to a bar, started drinking out of frustration, drank alcohol to stew up, came out with his car key, opened his jeep, entered the car. 10 minutes later, I started hearing, "Jesus!" Only him inside this car. "Jesus!" People started, "God, you know, okay, wait till you have." He said, "Child, car, when I just park here, Nana. They don't tip my steering, they don't tip my gear. They don't tip my steering, come on, the way that back here." And I tapped the man, "Bros, now back seat today, go front, you see steering." So after drinking, the man went to the back seat and started looking for his steering. I told him a story about two boys who are not born again, they went to take alcohol. But before I get to that point, two children, you know, sometimes are human too, with the fear. Two boys of about 8 years, 8 and 11 years, went to the market, stole oranges. Now took the oranges. They were looking for where to share the thing. They now went to a burial ground. While they were jumping the fence of the burial ground, two oranges fell down. They now entered the burial ground, started sharing the oranges. You know how children share things? One for me, one for you, one for me, one for you. One man crossing the burial ground started hearing, "One for you, one for me, one for you, one for me." He ran to his pastor. "Pastor, pastor!" "Say what?" "Come see your way God and then with a share dead body." "Come, come, come, pastor." "Say, eh?" "He said, God, koro, koro, one for you, one for me." "Then he share." The pastor followed the man to the burial ground. They now stood at the gate where the two oranges fell. They were not listening. "One for me, one for you, one for me, one for you." One of the boys now said, "Eh, what about the two at the gate?" The moment the pastor heard, "What about the two at the gate?" The husband, "Are you still here, amazing?" I said, "Son, a man of God, they don't want to see that. If you come to," they say, "train up a child in the way you go, but forget. You get children who don't sabi anything." They were doing competition, children competition. One came out. "My name is Emmanuel from Bassi Secondary School, Surulere, Lagos. O-N-E-1-T-W-O-2-T-H-R-E-E-3-F-O-U-R-4-F-I-V-E-5. See, the guy got to T-E-N-10. He clapped for him. Papa, papa, he went in. The next child came out. The only thing the guy heard from the other child was E-E-E. Everything was just sounding E-E. "My name is Chinua from Prince Winston Secondary School, Port Harcourt. O-N-E-E-1-E-W-O-2-E-H-R-E-E-3-E-O-U-R-4-E-I-V-E. They clap and say, "You try." But when they tell you evil children are very smart, don't doubt them. I'm telling you the truth. One evil boy, he knows nothing. The boy came out, My name is Chidi from Community Secondary School, Oka. O-N-E-E-1. That's the only thing the guy knows how to spell. But that Igbo child, the guy changed the thing. O-N-E-E-1, O-N-E-E plus O-N-E-E-2, O-N-E-E-2.